an average of 500 cases per day, Kampala is the highest. 100 cases per day, followed by Wakiso and Gulu, which have consistently reported over 100 cases per day. There is the map there. They can show you the map. The purple, that purple, like purple. It's red, deep red, but like purple. You see there it is Kampala and Wakiso. And in the north, it is Gulu. The blue or green, in this case, are they green or blue? Those are the ones without cases now, the green ones. The yellow ones have some cases. The white ones, are there white ones? They are where there are no cases, 1 to 20. So the green one, green, blue, they, I don't know how they look. Are they blue or green? The green ones are the ones without cases in the last 14 days. But Kampala, Gulu are the worst. As of today, cumulative cases, as of today, cumulative cases, all cases from the beginning, stand at 52,929. Reported confirmed death are at 374. And those who have recovered, 43,487. Currently, we have 634 patients. The ones who are severe are 277, and those who are critical are 37. These are all admitted at both public and private facilities. This means that only 8% of the confirmed cases in the last 14 days are on admission. That's very, very interesting. You hear that every day, like today, we had 1,259. That's what we had today, just in one day. But in the hospitals, we are talking of 634 together. The ones of today, the ones of yesterday, the ones of the day before. So that means many people are not in the hospitals. They are not in the hospitals. They are in the homes. That's what it means. We are concerned that this will exhaust the available bed space and oxygen supply in hospitals unless we constitute urgent public health measures. Public health measures are okwekingira bwe tugamba, okwekingira kusinga abaganda mugamba muti atwini okwekengera kusinga okuziyiza kusinga okuwona derinyankerwe okwetantara kukira okuraguza. Prevention is better than cure. That's what we mean by public health. You know, these people use words which they don't want you to understand, because if they understand, then you will be, you know as much as the doctor. So the doctors want to remain as mysterious as possible. So they say public health, as if you are, public health means prevention. They should simply use the words preventive health. If they say preventive health, even somebody from Rakhtar will understand it. So therefore, the answer is prevention. In this wave, the intensity of severe and critically ill COVID-19 patients and death is higher than what we experienced in the first wave of the pandemic. In the previous wave, it took us 3 to 4 months to get to the current state of critical and severe patients, while in the second wave, it has taken us less than 2 weeks to get to the same situation. At the beginning, it would take like 4 months to get the numbers we have got now. But now, within 2 weeks, we have got more numbers than we got in 4 months previously. There is a graph which they should show you. There you are. The Kasoria, the peak. You see that one? That was in December. And then it came down flat now. Oh, got to gain 7-9. We have now passed the other one, and we are still climbing to the mountain of danger. The most affected age group in this current wave are the young people, aged 20 to 39 years old, with observed increasing transmission among the 10 to 19 years old. Because when the problem started, the belief was that the group in trouble were the constituents of Jidudu. You know, we've got a honorable member of parliament for the aged. It's called Honorable Jidudu. And there are some old women in parliament there, the one with gray hair from Kampala area, and Mavengina from the north. That constituents of ours, of the 65 and above, are 3.3 million people. But this time they had been joined by the ones of 50. Even the ones of 50 were supposed to be in some danger. Those were the people supposed to be attacked and affected severely by this virus. But this time, because of the mutation, because the virus has changed, the new types are attacking the young ones also. So it is becoming a real problem. Now you show them this graph here. Now there, that tall tree you see, the tallest in the middle, are the 30 years and up to 39. Those are the ones who are affected, who are now infected most. The runners up, the ones who are next, on the left, on my left, are the 20 to 29 years. The third one is on the right. They're 40, 49 years. The number four on the left are the 10 years to 19 years. Now, my constituency is the one now which is the least affected. I don't know why. I think because they stay at home, they don't move so much. That must be the reason. Gidudu's constituency, the one on the right is 50 to 59 years. They are less. The 60 to 69, much less infected. The ones of 70, very little. It seems they run away and hid in their homes. And the one of 8 is almost zero. So the whole thing has changed. So if one wants to know, bring back that graph, bring it back. If one wants to know how this virus goes, there you have the answer. The more you move up and down, the more. Uh-huh. The Gidudu's constituency, the ones who have gone in hiding in the villages and in the homes, much less affected. So therefore, now the next graph is showing you the people who are admitted in hospitals. Show us that graph also. The ones who are admitted there, you are the tallest again, at the 2029, then 30-39, then 40. Again, they are the ones who are admitted most. But the red ones are the ones who are critical. The ones who are critical. The green ones are the severe. These graphs will be published in the newspapers. You'll be able to see them. From the recent data on projection, this situation is expected to further escalate as a result of A, poor compliance by the population to follow the SOPs and my directives. That's the main reasons of GM. Nanta Burirwa, Betugamba. Nanta Burirwa, Yasawara Nawabumba. You remember I told you that in my Uganda the other time. Somebody was told, please, clay does not make boats. Don't make a clay boat. He said, Zenimugezi, me, I'm clever, I'll make a boat out of clay. And the man went in, and when he was a few meters from the shore, the clay cracked, and the man died. So this is the main cause. Poor compliance by the population to follow SOPs and my directives. You remember in the elections, people said that the reason we were stopping holding rallies was because we wanted to stop the Honorable Chagurani and the groups from organizing politically. You remember? And then the Europeans and all those groups. So now, you have now seen what congregating can do. B, there is an increased number of clusters of infections in schools since March 2021. You remember we opened schools You remember last year, I sent home 15 million children. And when those children were in the villages, I didn't hear of any infection. 15 million. I didn't hear of any infection. If it was there, I didn't hear about it. Now, when we opened the schools, that has now become a new center of infections. A total of 948 reported cases in 43 schools from 22 districts have been reported. Kampala, Guru, Masaka, and Oyam districts combined constitute 61% of the reported cases in schools and higher institutions of learning. We believe this number is much higher, only that most schools are not reporting. Some schools are hiding. They are hiding because they want to keep the schools open for many reasons, not for health, not for godliness, but for money. And you know how money caused the problems for Judas. Judas Iscariot. Money. So children should die because of money. So some institutions are hiding. The high number of infections in schools is largely attributed to poor compliance to SOPs, inadequate sanitation facilities, in spite of the fact, you see, when we opened the schools, we said, let only the completers be the ones to come. We first allowed the S4s of last year, and the S6s and the P7s. They went and sat for the exams and went out. Then we said the next group come in. So really, the people who are in school now are like 10% of the total potential school population. But still, and the logic was that they have enough space. They can social distance, they don't have to congregate, but some of the people don't care. Some of the people don't bother. So therefore, overcrowding in some schools. Failure by some school administration to monitor signs and symptoms among the learners and timely reporting. Remember, we told you that when you see somebody with senior-like things, report. I have had I don't know how many tests. Whenever I have like an allergy, sometimes I get some allergies. Even these masks. You remember the other time my voice disappeared. It was this mask which caused that irritation of my throat. So sometimes it causes me some allergy. Like the other time when I went to Tanzania, I came back with some allergy in the nose, and I had to go for test. Do I have corona? I have had tests like three times in the recent, because of when I have like a flu or like an allergy, I test for corona. But fortunately, whenever I test, I didn't. I was negative because I don't want to. If I have the corona, I shouldn't infect other people. I should stay in the home or in isolation. During the campaign, some young people around us here got corona. When I was about to go to Rukunjiri, I had to test first before I could go to Rukunjiri. I was in Rwaxtra. I would have had to change the model of the campaign, maybe address the Rukunjirians through the radio and not go there. So we said, please, if you see any signs, test, report. and let them check, and then you can be able to isolate that person, then you save the bigger group. But if you keep it, if you keep such a person in the group, then instead of having two people, you will now have 100. And then concealment of infections in some schools by the school administrators. The entry of new variants that the Minister of Health first reported at the beginning of March 2021, in addition to the original Wuhan strain, Wuhan is the other Chinese one, have been noticed. The variant strains specifically, like the Indian variant B1617, the South African variant B1351, and the UK variant B117 are more aggressive and tend to cause sustained transmission and a shift of the most affected age groups from the older individuals to the younger age groups. This is because of the travelers that would come into the country with purported negative PCR test results, yet they were infected. To date, we have confirmed a total of 126 cases from travelers coming in from the airport. It is for this reason that the government, working with the private sector, instituted mandatory PCR testing at the airport. PCR is to check for the presence of the virus in the body, as opposed to antibody. Because some of the tests, you check the body reaction to the virus. But the PCR is when you look for the mulambo, either mulambo, the dead body of the virus, or fragments of it, or fragments of the virus. This is what these doctors want to keep you out of information. PCR is somebody in Rakitura, PCR will think possibly you are talking about a nightclub or something like that. So they have put PCR, this looking for the Obutundu Tundu, the fragments of the virus at the airport for travelers from high-risk countries. The sustained transmission within the communities by infected persons who fail to adhere to the principles of home-based care. If you get infected and you go into your home, please keep away from your family and from others. You take one room somewhere in the house, say, Mundeke, don't come here, you people. Don't go in the sitting room to talk. Just isolate yourself for the sake of your family. The sustained transmission within the community by the infected persons who fail to adhere to the principles of home-based care, e.g. strict isolation from your family, adhering to full-time use of face masks, even in the home. Here, I'm not using my mask here, I have it. But because all these people have got a kshankara, you know, the Nyankore word for mask is a kshankara, which we put on the mouth of the calf, not to suckle the mother. So since all these fellows have got a shankar on them, that's why I'm not putting in mind so that I can speak better. So when you're in the home and there is a case in the home, put on the mask all the time. Adhering to full-time use of the face masks, hand washing, and no movement out of home until one is declared COVID-19 negative. If they do not adhere to the home-based care principles above, they pose a serious risk to the general population. There is generalized laxity in the response by most districts, resulting in several clusters of transmission. The district task forces, chaired by the RDCs in all districts, are the bedrock of the COVID-19 response. I'm informed that most of these task forces are not meeting to guide the response. Important to note is that since my last address on the 29th of May, a total of 6,308 new cases from 57 districts have been reported. Currently, 81 districts have high sustained transmission. These include Kampala, Wakiso, Gulu, Luwero, Mbarara, Mbale, Tororo, Moroto, Masaka, Busia, Nabilatuk, Amuru, Lira, Moyo, Arua, Lamo, Karungu, Rubirizi, and Yumbe. This resurgence happened after government had developed some capacity to manage COVID-19 in the form of enhancement of skills and numbers of our human resources, installation of new intensive care units, high dependency unit equipment, procurement and installation of oxygen plants in all regional referral hospitals, procurement of ambulances for emergency evacuation of patients, and re-operationalization of Nambore to manage moderate to severe cases. So when this virus epidemic started, we started building capacity. So we have some capacity now. That's what I've been saying in this section. The current hospital beds to manage COVID-19 patients stand at 3,793 beds, as summarized below. Mulago National Referral Hospital, standard beds, 600. People can't read those. Don't waste time. I will tell them. Those are too small. 600 beds, standard. High dependency unit, 300. Intensive care, 27. Mulago Women's Hospital, high dependency, 60. Regional referral hospitals together, ordinary beds, standard beds, 900. Standard beds, but dedicated to corona. Dedicated to corona, not beds for malaria, for Ichuduka, no. Those are also there. These are specifically for Akaoka, for this corona. So the regional referral hospitals, 900 together. High dependency in the regional referral, 115. Intensive care units in the regional hospital, 150. Nambore general beds, 1,300. Bombo Military Hospital, 120 standard beds, 10 ICU, intensive care units. Private facilities, 7 of them have been accredited. Standard bed is 180, intensive care unit 31. So standard beds for corona, 3,100. High dependency beds, 475. Intensive care beds, 2018. In addition to this, government continues to mobilize non-traditional treatment facilities in the form of field hospitals to provide additional capacity for asymptomatic to mild and moderate cases. In the worst case scenario, should cases rapidly escalate and overwhelm the above bed capacity, government will install a 300-bed field hospital per regional referral hospital, thus providing an additional 4,500 beds. That is to say, if the problem becomes worse, then we, near the referral hospital, we build their tents and we turn them into temporary hospitals. So that will create an additional 4,500 beds. The current rise in the COVID-19 infections in the country can only be stopped if all the people of Uganda take personal responsibility for protecting themselves, their families, and communities where they live and work. You have seen that in the spread, Gidudu's constituency now is less affected. The elderly, because we told them, please, you stay at home. The other day I was in, when we were in Chankwanzi, I talked with one of the army officers there. I said, how is your mother? He said, I took her to the village because of the corona. So this army officer took his mother to the village to get out of the infection area. Okwewala, you will not get to avoid congregating, you will not get the disease. So you take personal responsibility for protecting yourself. Uganda has well-established structures for coordinating and governing the population, such as LOCs in all the villages, cultural and religious leaders, and organized groups such as taxi or border operators. We used these structures in the past to defeat HIV, Ebola, and other epidemics. So therefore, if you take responsibility for protecting yourselves, your families, and communities where you live and work, it can work. It is effective if you bother. In October 2020, the government launched the National Community Engagement Strategy for COVID-19 response, which has been distributed to all the districts in Uganda. This strategy has guided on how to establish village COVID-19 task forces across all the 146 districts and how to provide home-based care when needed. I call upon all district leaders, including LOCs, cultural and religious leaders, to use existing structures and systems to ensure that SOPs are observed in the villages and during village functions, and the village health teams are supported to mobilize people to report illness and support communities as guided in the Ministry of Health guidelines for home-based care and support. The government has vaccinated a total of 748,676 people across the country. 712,681 people with the first dose, and 35,995 with the second dose of AstraZeneca vaccine out of the 964,000 doses received so far. Government appreciates the Ugandan's enthusiasm to access the vaccine since my last address. 86,000 377 people have been vaccinated in a period of 7 days in comparison to 78,791 vaccinated in the previous 7 days. Government is committed to vaccinate all the 21.9 million eligible Ugandans, starting with the priority groups of 4.8 million people. These priority groups are the health workers, 150,000, teachers, 550,000, security personnel, 250,000, the elderly, all those above 50 years old, 3.3 million, and people who have other diseases like cancer, high blood pressure, diabetes, liver, heart and kidney disease, 500,000. Uganda vaccination rollout efforts have been hampered by the global vaccine shortages and amplified by the resurgence of COVID-19 in India since February 2021. The other day at Korora, I spoke about this, so I don't want to speak about it again. This situation in India, given its large population, has delayed the global vaccine delivery commitments to countries on time. However, government is making all attempts to ensure that we secure additional doses to cover all the targeted groups. Don't remove from TV because of taking my coffee, please. For Baganda Tugamba, nti akatari kabbe, amagomba, olya osura mulyango. These people don't know our culture. Nyede kaho yange nunkweka. Stop all this buyaism. This is my coffee. This is the lubricant for the throat. Uganda is expecting to receive an additional 175,000 doses for the vaccine through the COVAX facility. This is AstraZeneca. So please, you people, you vaccinate second round, the ones who have already. Yes, first finish those. Because if you don't, then that one will be wasted. In fact, I wouldn't want you to vaccinate new ones until you finish second round the other ones, so that we have that complete group. In addition, government will secure 300,000 doses of Sinovac vaccine donated by our friends, the Chinese government. But I want to buy. I don't want to depend on donations. We shall buy. We shall buy from Johnson & Johnson, the Americans, from these Chinese, and even from the Russians, the Sputnik. We shall get the doses. I would like to remind you all that COVID-19 control and prevention is a responsibility of everyone. I therefore urge all Ugandans to adhere to the COVID-19 SOPs, wash hands with soap and water frequently, wear face masks, social distancing, avoid mass gatherings, avoid touching your mouth, nose, and eyes. avoid closed spaces, open windows fully, avoid crowds, markets, malls, avoid individuals with signs and symptoms of COVID-19 or ordinary senyiga, cold, avoid them. Ensure good health, physical exercise, good nutrition, and exposure to sunshine. These have been shown to be beneficial in limiting COVID-19 transmission and severe disease. In addition to our natural foods, we should emphasize plenty of fruits rich in vitamin C, such as lemon, orange juice, limes, tomatoes, pineapples, etc., and vegetables. Vitamin D is essential for reducing the severity of the COVID-19. It is therefore important that we add meat, especially beef liver, eggs, fatty fish such as Nile perch, especially the skin and the fish eggs, and all other sources of vitamin D in addition to exposure to the morning sun. The other sources of vitamin D are white beans, soya beans, soya milk, sun-dried mushrooms, and some vegetables such as spinach and okra. In light of the above, and with the guidance from the National Task Force and the scientists, the government has revised the control measures to address the current situation as follows. Number one, all schools and institutions of higher learning to close for 42 days, effective 8 a.m., 7th of June, 2021. This school should close from tomorrow. All of them. From tomorrow, 8 a.m., school should close. The ones, all the schools that had been open, the finalists, as we call them, as we used to call them at Chamate, the goers, the ones who are going, and would go with our chorus up like this. We are goers. So the goers, please, for now, for 42 days, you go home. We debated this issue very seriously, because there was a debate that, oh, if they go home, these children are not going to infect their people. Yes, that risk, but the risk of staying together, the risk of staying together is bigger than the risk of dispersal. Dispersing. The strategy here is to avoid concentrations. And you avoid concentration by dispersing. So, all the schools to close from tomorrow, 8 a.m. All teachers to fully get vaccinated before they are accepted in schools. All the teachers must be vaccinated. The other day I saw one of my competitors, one of the presidential candidates, Mr. Kabureta. I had not seen that man. I got a chance to see him on TV. I had not seen him, although we were competing, but we didn't get a chance to exchange. But I saw him saying that employers have no right to force somebody to be vaccinated. I beg your pardon. If we are in a workplace, and for health reasons we say that this is required and you don't do it, please, you don't come. We may not force you, but we may not force you to take the vaccine, but you shall not come to the workplace. So, presidential candidate Cavaletta, please check your list of rights. Yes, you have got your right to boycott the vaccine, but we have also got the right to protect ourselves from you. So any teacher who is not vaccinated will not teach. Should not be allowed in the school. Communal prayers in mosques, churches, or in stadia and other open air venues are suspended for 42 days. That issue, I don't know why some people were insisting on opening these churches and mosques. Really, I am lucky. I have a bishop in my house. For the first time in 150 years, I had never had a bishop in my house since Christianity came in 1877. But one of my daughters is a bishop now, a pastor, Patience Kukundeka, Ruawogo. When they were opening, she asked my opinion. I said, please, 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 Patience, don't open that church because God is in all places. You preach through the radio. And I'm glad my home-based bishop listened to my advice. So this idea that you must be in the church, that God is in the church or in the mosque. I've got some fundamentalist people here like Msenero. Msenero is one of the fundamentalist Christians. Diana Twin is a moderate type. I don't know the other fundamentalists, but Okia is also a fundamentalist. Okia, I had to force him to go for a master's because he had become a preacher. But he's doing more work now as a consultant. So you, please, I don't know where this idea came from of saying that God is in the mosque, that is in the church, because when I did my catechism, 1957, when I was in P5, in Runyankwere in Katesichimu, they said, Rahanga Ryumyanya Yona Yona. God is omnipresent. That's how they say it in English, omnipresent. So God, please, we'll hear you wherever you are. So please, this gathering our people, that when they saw such a clear danger, is not correct. So communal prayers in mosques, churches, or stadia and other open air venues are suspended for 42 days. Online prayers are encouraged. Public and cultural gatherings or conferences, except for the sitting of the cabinet, the legislature and judiciary, are hereby suspended for 42 days. We are talking of 42 days for scientific reasons, because when you get infected, the idea that infection will show in 14 days. Is that not the logic? That if you are infected today, ogenda okumalenda kukuminanya oradde unawa vudeyo, the sickness will show up. So therefore, to be sure, the 42 days are three bisanja of infection. 14 days, in case we didn't see properly, we give you another 14, that's 28 days. But to be sure, 42 days. That is three times. Abiru Munana, 28, two Visanja, three, you go to 42. And actually, if people behave well, because this disease is very easy, it's actually easy to stop. It's very easy to stop. Like you have seen what happened. When we took serious measures, by December, there were no cases, almost. Up to March, up to April. We didn't have cases. And you have seen the elderly, when they avoid, the infection is now very low. So we can actually totally, because if somebody has got corona and he keeps to himself for 15 days or 28 days, it will be over. It will be out of him. And if it is out of him, he will not infect anybody. So that's why we talk of the 42 days. Travel from Category A countries, as defined by the Minister of Health, remain suspended except for returning Ugandans. At the moment, only India is listed as Category A. But that list may be revised by the Minister of Health as the situation evolves. Agricultural activities which are cultivating or plowing gardens, herding livestock, whether free range or zero grazing, and fishing for fish, including fish farming, to continue. This should continue because, fortunately, most of them do not encourage crowding. Oburunzi, oburimi, obuvubi, tubirina kizibu ky'amaanyi. Kubanga abantu tubeekunganya nnyo. So those should continue. The non-agricultural activities that will be allowed to continue are factory activities, construction activities, shopping malls, supermarkets, all these to continue while observing SOPs issued by the Minister of Health. We are debating about these shopping malls and supermarkets. But I decided to give them a chance to see, okay, let's give them a chance for 1 week. If they observe the SOPs, then we can ignore them. But otherwise, there was an opinion that they should be closed because they spread infection, because people gather there. And in any case, they specialize selling imported goods. Because they don't sell our own products. They sell imported merchandise. These gathering points, such as factories, hotels, large plantations, markets, taxi parks, etc., should be allowed to operate under strict observance of SOPs. So like in the factories, people should work, but should not be very squeezed. You discuss that with the Minister of Health. And people should be putting on masks. These must observe strict SOPs. Failure to comply within a week will lead to complete closure. Marriage ceremonies, parties, and all other social gatherings are only allowed with a maximum of 20 people. 20. Makumiyabiri. Pierre Ario. 2020. Ishirini. Under strict observance of SOPs. House parties are strictly banned, and this would be enforced without fail. All guests, when you go to these marriage ceremonies of 20 people, wear masks and keep physical distance. Because you remember, I told you of the scientific wedding. I said, why do you bring all these people, all these irrelevant people, to the marriage? Because the marriage is just needed some few essential elements: future husband, future wife, two parents times two, that is four. So flower girl, two, the priest, the matron, so all the others are just they don't have a particular role, just to sit and eat. The best man and lady of honor. That's all you need. Number of persons at burials, vigils, and funerals should not exceed 20 people, or should wear masks and social distance. 11, weekly non-food markets, known as Miburo markets, are suspended for 42 days throughout the country. 12, also suspended for 42 days, are the monthly cattle auction markets, Ebukomera. The danger with these markets is that people come from different places. You don't know where they have come from. They come together for some hours and then they go back. That's a perfect arrangement for spreading the disease. Come from 20 multiple directions, spend a day together, then go back. That's the best way to oxiga already, to propagate the sickness. 13, all public transport, buses, taxis, borders, between and across districts are suspended for 42 days, effective 10th of June, 2021. Public transport from district to district, inter-district, is suspended for 42 days from the 10th of July, of June. This is to allow our children to go home, the students who are in the school. Otherwise, I would have said immediate. But I give you 3 days, 4 days to operate, and then we shall stop them. All inter-district travel banned except travel within Kampala, metropolitan, Kampala, Wakiso, Mukono. Inter-district travel, stop it. Stay where you are. Don't go from Mbarara to come to Kampala to... No. Stay in Mbarara for 42 days. Don't come to Kampala. Don't go from here to Mbarara. No. Exemption for inter-district travel and movement of vehicles are cargo trucks. Cargo trucks, the trucks which carry food, which carry cargo, those should move. registered tourist vehicles also should move. Essential and emergency services vehicles. Public transport within the same district is allowed with strict observance of SOPs as previously described. So within Kampala, public transport will be allowed to continue operating. Some people wanted it to be closed, but I said no. How about the factories? How will the factory workers go to work? But all this is if they observe SOPs. Don't carry many people in the taxi, and so on. Put on masks, sanitizing, and so on. If they don't, we may have to suspend them also. Cargo trucks are allowed only 2 people. When it's a cargo truck, just 2 people, the driver and somebody else. Tourist vehicles must observe SOPs as spelled out. Bars, discos, music shows, cinemas, and concerts remain closed. Sports events will only operate under strict observance of SOPs with no spectators. All players must have negative PCR tests. So abazanyi will be can run and play football in the stadium, but without spectators. We can see them on TV. And I sometimes, when I'm looking for UBC and some channels, sometimes I see sports channels in Europe. I am here, I see people playing football in Europe. So you don't have to be in the stadium. If there is a danger, we go to the stadium when there is no danger. But if there is danger, why do we go? All public places, markets, offices, shopping malls are directed to maintain strict hygiene, ensure people coming in are sanitized before entry, physical distancing, and appropriate use of face masks all the time. Encourage people to work from home whenever possible and revert to 30% physical presence at workplace for 42 days. And my office, all these people don't have to come. For the office people, only 30% should come. Not more than that. The heads of the office is to organize that. For 1 month, so and so, so and so, so and so are the only ones who will come. Then after 1 month, you check the others and they can come and the other ones stay at home. Institutions, organizations, and workplaces to have persons dedicated to compliance. Each area to have a nyampara to check compliance. Private vehicles should be restricted to not more than 3 people, including the driver. Private vehicles. The other ones are public. Private ones can move, but only with. But also the private vehicles, we don't allow them between districts. Even if you have got a private vehicle, we have stopped inter-district movement. So when I say private vehicles, I'm talking of within the district. Within the district. Inter-district movement is stopped for 14 days. Because you see, what you want to stop the infection. And whether you are one or in a government vehicle, a private vehicle, you can carry the virus. So stay where you are. Ambulances, security vehicles, and garbage collection vehicles are allowed to operate normally. Shopping arcades, hardware shops, and any other commercial entity to operate under strict observance of SOPs and must close at 7 p.m. countrywide. Failure to comply will lead to total closure. Owners and managers will be held liable for breach of SOPs. Exception will be given to pharmacies to operate beyond 7 p.m. The shops selling medicine, those will be exempted until the curfew time. As I said, supermarkets will remain open and operate with strict observance of SOPs and close at 7 p.m. Owners must enforce the use of masks and sanitizers in the workplace at all the time. The food markets should continue operating but enforce SOPs. The market leaders will be held liable for non-compliance to SOPs. Saloons, lodges, and garages are allowed to operate up to 7 p.m. with the strict SOPs. Lodges should be allowed to operate, but bars in these places should not be operational. Lodges without bars. And you know why we are against bars? Because drunkards cannot understand SOPs. I think if you want to get drunk, can't you get drunk in your house? Yes. I don't know why these drunkards really want to cause us a problem. Because if you want to get drunk, given the danger which is there, go buy the beers, take them to your house, and then you can drink, and you lie on the floor there. We shall not be there. Why do you want to gather? Factories are allowed to continue operating under strict observance of SOPs and where need arises, work in shifts. Construction sites are allowed to continue under strict observance of SOPs. As I've said before, lorries should not have more than 2 persons. We shall continue to work with the EAC member states to strengthen cross-border surveillance. Private cars, as I've said, are allowed to cross the border into the neighboring countries, provided they observe SOPs and occupants have a negative PCR test result. Curfew shall remain at 2100 hours, that is 9 p.m., from 2100 hours to 5:30 a.m. and vigorously enforced, except for cargo, trucks, lorries, pickups, trains, and aircraft. For health emergencies during curfew, this will be dealt with by the security on the basis of the case-by-case basis. The RDC should take over in the rural areas. Borders are allowed to transport goods and or one passenger up to 6 p.m. for the next 42 days. Failure to comply within one week will lead to complete closure. Enforcing directives and the responsibility should lie with the owners of the premises with security. Violation of these measures will lead to fines that will be given out soon in a statutory instrument signed by the Permanent Secretary to the Treasury. So instead of arresting people and filling jails and wasting your time. Aha. This time, Akasente, we thought, why do we waste time with arresting these people? You violate, you pay. Uh-huh. And the Secretary for Treasury is going to issue such an instrument, and he will issue security-controlled receipt books. When you violate, Bakuba Kakongi, they give you a default ticket and you're going to pay in the bank. We don't want our people to touch money. Your number remains on the counter for you and you go and you pay. Secretary for Treasury will issue this statute because the ministers are not there now. But the Secretary for Treasury will do it. I will authorize her to do it. Authorize him. Those who do not care about the health of Ugandans will pay financially. All the above directives, except where explicitly stated, take immediate effect. Government will continuously observe the compliance and make necessary adjustments. The enforcement of the above directives does not only lie with the law enforcers, but also the owners of public transport organizations, owners of premises, and individuals. If you fail to comply within 1 week, I will enforce total lockdown. In order to ensure this, I had set up a task force monitoring group headed by Major General Muhesi, and including Dr. Museni Robert. I think Muhesi had some is indisposed. So I now appoint Major General Rusoke to work with Dr. Msenero to enforce. The other group of General Chanda was involved also, that those should go back to the army because they cause multiple things will cause confusion. So it is now Rusoke, Msenero, these are the monitors. And I authorize them to use the police network, our cameras, see who is violating. Because you can see. And then you take action. So I thank you, and I wish you good luck. But before I end today, although the talk is about Corona, I thought I should talk a little bit about security. Also, the other day at Kororo, I talked a bit about security, but I was talking about many things. But I have been reading papers, and I saw some people writing, especially in the monitor. That monitor has got all sorts of very confused people. One of these days, I will answer them. I actually picked one of their papers some weeks ago and kept it. And when I have time, I will answer them. Now, when they are dealing with the security, they now want spread pessimism and worry about security. And from what I could see, they were making 3 points. Point number one was, these people who are killing people, who have been killing people even in the past, investigations are done, but they are never completed. That's one line. Then the second one is with the shooting at Katumba recently. Oh, a whole general has been shot. At Efabalala. If a whole general can be shot, how about us? How about us? It seems the situation is very bad. Situation is very bad. Because if a whole general can be shot, then how about we? So I think we should run away and go to Nani. I don't know, go where. Then thirdly, now this one I saw, I think it was yesterday or today, I saw it in the that bad paper called Monitor. So the elite, the elite are not sleeping. They are worried about their security. In the past, the elite ran away out of Uganda, but now they're in a dilemma. They don't know where to run away because they have a lot of property. They don't want to leave it here. So they are like the hyena. The hyena, one day the hyena was swallowing a hot something. It was hot. It couldn't swallow. Then somebody said, okay, if you can't swallow, then you spit. So it couldn't spit because it was sweet. It couldn't swallow because it was hot. So the monitor was saying that the elite are now stuck because they have a lot of property. But they are worried. They want to run away. But if they run away, how will they leave their property? Now, before I speak, I brought one of my fighters, because I normally have Olwanyi Banange. Olwaka Lwani Kanange, Getwalwani Entaro, Njangara Otegeza abantu bano engeri gye twalwanamu. Tugera mu Luganda by'oluzungu bireke bisitawanye oluzungu lwatukooye narwo.
Naye nsa muzee amanya nze na shamba the rest. Abajjukira emboozi ey'ebijambi ye Kalungu yenze. Njagala okwebaza muzeeyi kunsonga ya security. Ekintu kya General Katumba ekyabaddewo mu butuufu nga kyeraliikiriza muko naye ate twebaza Katonda nti kati nze nga ku nsonga yange ebyaliwo ebijambiya abakyamu basobola okukola ebintu naye tebajja bikolera lubeerera ekiseera kyabwe kituuka ne kikola ki ne kigwako we tutuuse kati mu Uganda security si yeraliikiriza ennyo kati we tuli. Njagala okugumya bannayuganda nti ku nsonga ya security nze ndi mugumu olw'ensonga nti omukulembeze gwe tuyina ebintu biyinza okuba nga ebitambula empola oba abakyamu bakola bye bakola ne babula naye buli baddi era balikwatibwa ebintu bino biriggwawo ani yali amanyi nti e Kalungu ebijambiya birikoma abantu ne beebaka ku tulo ekiri e Kalungu olwaleero actually okuva lwe bakwata ab'ebijambiya bakidde balime ne group ye abantu kati abeetema beetemera bibanja bintu birala naye ng'abantu beebaka si kyekiri ekyaliwo kyasemba ku nze teri kyakizeemu kubeerawo kati olw'okuba nti ebitongole by'obukuumi bikola omulimu gwabyo tuyinza obutabitegeera ffenna nga bannayuganda kyekigenda mu maaso naye nze ndi mugumu nti n'abaalumbye General Katumba yadde bayinza okuba bakola mu nkola yemu base n'abantu abalala mu ngeri bwetyo afandika wesi n'abalala naye era tubeere bagumu na kino kijja kuggwa
tubuulire ekyaffe
ekyaffe waliwo gurupu y'abavubuka baali babiri e Masaka eyo naye mu kusooka era nga bannayuganda batuteebereza abantu baali bamanyi nti kibinja ky'abantu bangi nnyo gwali mwezi gwa kutaano kyali kiro lwali lwa mande nze nali mu nyumba nga neebase
mwezi gwa kutaano mwaka ki
2018 nali mu nyumba kiro nga neebase mu nyumba twalimu abantu babiri nze n'omwana omuwala omulala kubanga ennyumba ya projekita we nali mbeera nga tulimu abantu babiri nsula ludde eno naye asula sayidi eri ngenda okuwulira omuntu alinga akwata ku luggi olw'emiryango Mukamera na yeye yanzo kusakatunda yeye wunisa nazuko kana simu yangu ngangu kuti mungalo wenti nsalen zire mchisenge chomwa na ndavi ya afumi wa weru guempulire weru okusala okudda mu kisenge ng'omuntu wono tuna nti wabanga omulyango gw'emiryango muggulu omuntu yafulumi nganda bakati ni buli kimu kiri bulungi natukira mu kisenge ky'omwana okubikula kati ninze namuzi okusaba okubikula net ninze najijayo ne muyita Susan ne mubuze simu yerwa kubanga nalengera omuntu nga flashinga torch went kati nalowoza bafulumye na simu ne mubuze simu yerwa najindaga no mutima gane kungambira nti kati ebweru babbi ne mugamba tukubire ne iba wafe maso na ngamba musawo sina ko ya time ne nkwate yangi ne nkubira ne iba wangandi maso nge simu yete liko ne nkubira omwami omulala bamuyita omwami mugeja ne iba wange wagulu ne mugamba tata mati ni nyamba ndaba abantu we wange naye balabika babbi nzija kuna ine namba ya osi mujagalo mu kubita tata mati ni anziriza ambuza musawo chichi kati nasoka kwate tata mati ni ne munaye ngendo jikwata ngoro mpulira emiryango ba endabirwa muzika olujinge endabirwa mbajikubi kati nakwata bukwa sisimu ne nkubanduru nga kunetandiko kubenduru nkubenduru nnyo nnyo ngo mchonga engungamba bwe bawulira nti tukubenduru bagenda genda naye ngendo kuulira ntebe mudiro bazisindika ne manya nti kati bayingide esimu ne njija ko sajinda nakuzikirira dana ne njisa mudisa ne njisulebwe ngendo kuulira nga basamba olujirwa kisengerwe twalimu kubanga bwe manya kumanya nti babinzira ku lujendo siba Nesimu njisura yansanga sinajayo na mkono kwenti mudirisa. Na ngambo oleka na chisirika njagala sent. Nientambula na wani nzira mchisenge change. Mwenzira mchisenge change na vo. Na ine sawo jenali nkoze na yon zinu zituka kumugongo. Mwenimu aidine bintu vila lalala. Nzija mwe mituwa levili na ichitundu kuwanga jejalimu. Njibawa. Niba ngambo saa gago jakuleta sent. Niba gamba zenina. Niba gana. Niba soka. Niba kebera. Niba nonya nonya kawo. Naye ngo mutima gundi wagwero simu je nakubyo bagwe nagambi ya kitegedde simani banonyeza nonyeza kidawali mesa onajuka ku mugongo na ateka mu ebirije ne bafuluma bwe bafuluma nduwoza bagenze nesibira yo mu kisenge nyingira wansi we kitanda kasera katono nnyo nyendo okuya bakomye okulujiba ku nkona gulawo oli na mugambo obya obafulumye ntia amwali yesibidem nyendo okuya naloba rusambye Yasamba ogusoka ni mfuluma yone nyingira mu kinabiru kisenge wano kinabiru nesara nenzira mu kinabiru gasichaina na wakwe kweka akati bwe bayingira era yasoka kumulisa wansi wa kitanda ngamanje ne kwese mbalengera mu kinabiru nyimiride bangambole medecent naye wano mukusoka ngatwa na fuluma kisenge change banonyeza zibabuzi awunange nunye nsawo nze na zeti nkulire bitanda ne mifaliso nenji chusa ngambagama ne wano tereka ho sente neno neno naye ngangula budde abajja basobolo tusanga Bwenyingira mu kinabiro bayingidde kiddawali bawanyisanga ekisenge lije bansanga balowooza bagye nali nterese ssente kuba kyo bakitinkula nnyo n'okusinga ebisenge byonna. Ono bwakusigalako ssente oziganidde ogenda kufa toli musawo musala abantu leero nze ngenda okusala. N'oyo n'agenda kiddawali menadda kagali akalala gali wangu nako ne kadda bwe batyo. Kati kiddawali maba ansigaddeko. Angambo ganidde ssente kale weyambule. Nali ndi mu night nangamba jamu empale ninebikula nangamba bikula ina simu nene bulungi nyatandiko kuba ebifaananyi bwangamba chuka amala ngamba jangu mve mu kisenge mu kitabu mu kinabiri we nali nzire ku kisenge nzire mu kisenge lwali bamande tuva mu weekend nani tadeke sunga yange tukula enkuba yali tonyo wabwe batambula nebigato katinga ebigere wansi bichafu ntunu yobuliri bwange bwe ngenda ko mugamba kanabe ke ebigere naye nga wona kubuzabuza Na yimirira na ninda kati au tulira omuntu wabwe ngatambula linya mubigira semiryango kidawali mayita afande afande okumala ya afande omulundi ogwo kubiri nituulire sasi wabwe nanto omukono na afuluma au nawiranga mpulira ninga baba dalo otanga ninga abadde abiranga mvayo kwenti naye nga ninda nga ngamba agenda komawo agambe tufa bameka tufa babiri Kati hawa mthasi geyongera wabweru, geyongera chide wanimu kuyagenda teyada na sigara nyimide mchifochimu wenti ngangambo bako mao teyada. Mthasi ne geyongera wabweru kati balibe nari nkubide, obaliba kubide osi, aze na basirikala abalala. Gari wangaduka mkavu yako, basi gaza chide walimeba mkwata, osi ya jano mwami mla kure mpreventa chakua. Ngaba kuata chida walime na yeye yabaluwa nyisa ya luwa na ageza kukuduka, ageza kukubuka akatimba na yeye mkama wachisa. Nebamu kuata abantu lube yonge domame nogina kubira kubira abantu bonna okubanga abantu bali bakoye kati yakubira abantu kubanga gwali mundi gwa kubira koma okuchara abantu bonna ne bajja kati nzingendo okufulumanga mpulye kidde wali maka abale kana fande nsonyi wa fande ngonze naye ngapulire dobo zilimu siulira lya kubira nzira mudirisa ngamba fande bali babiri taliyo omu ngabanga ambo omwaduse awe mfunira amanya agafuluma Bwana tuka kuchidawali mme, na muku bebi konde, nga nuku mpulida tebi monoga na bulunji, kubayi alimu kambu, olisi manye na kumanya. Na yoku mtu kakunga wansa maguru tacha, enu wagurunga jasitula, nga maguru wansi tacha nyenya. Urabantube yonge de, abama inja, abakolachi, ato mutima munda, nga musajaba genda mutida muno munda, njaga luga, mpabane ba mfulima wabweru, nga aba, ntamalobozi maititipu, nga tuina na wachisa. Fainale mainja bichi ni mamu kuwa nafida. Bwamalo kufa osi amujamu, amukuwa cheka amujamu echipapula. Ngachiriko ebifananyi byabwe bibiri. Kubabali babati imbi endoza masaka muno bachi no bachi timbula wasimanyi. Ngachidawali machi ina musawo chiriko wanted. Omusirika inaga mbabano si bebana abatu loka mkoti ya masaka emisana bebanonya. Na chindaga wendi, kuwa mataragari kumu nyumba nga nabalavadu, njine mugamba bebano. Katikubantuwe bali babo mnundi ogwa soka, bali wone babalaga, omwami munagamba bebana, abana abanzi mnundi ogwa soka. Awo, msirika inatandiko kuwa masimu, neba kuweka lungu, hava prison, neba jia, neba kumfami, nganga yechida walime. Buati omukama kwa yansasira.
Oli yaduka?
Yaduka, uluvanyima rwa wike, mbamu kuatira, Ntunga meyo.
Yes. So, Kati, so therefore, thank you very much.
Welcome, sir.
This is my co-fighter, the Chambadde.
Yes, sir.
You can see this Chidawarime group are the people who had killed 5 people on New Year's Day. Ya New Year's Day ya mwaka wa 18?
2017, as we are entering 2018.
Aha. Uh-huh. So this group, this fellow, Chidawari Me, who was killed trying to rob and rape her, had been involved in killing 5 people on New Year's Day of 2018, there had been a disco. You know, Ugandans have been used to esanyu, to laxity. So there was a disco in Kisojo there. Is it Zimbabwe or what? Of Kobansimbi. Now. During that New Year's Day, when there was a lot of music, they came to rob a wife of a school owner. School owner had a husband who was working in Mbende. She was a woman. And because there was a lot of disco, they were making alarm, but nobody was hearing them. But somehow one of the boys came, and the group which was trying to break into the school owner's home ran. But as they were running, they killed 5 people on the way, including a former police officer whom they invaded, and he tried to fight and they killed him. So that group continued terrorizing the massacre area. But they were doing it using laxity. You see, for instance, when the school owner, whom they tried to rob, instead of ringing the police, she rang her husband in Mbende. Her husband in Mbende rang the regional police commander in Masaka. Regional police commander is the one who rang the police in the Bukomansimba, I think it was. And by that time, these people had left. But because of the ritual scuffle, you see, that's why people shouldn't really exaggerate the problem of criminals, because they would be defeated. But in their going, they dropped a phone. And from the phone, the police were able to get other things, to know that this was some of them. But still, the issue was not solved. But what happened was that this time, we organized the area to say, now, if the criminals come, you don't ring far, you ring the DPC nearest to you. Don't go too far. Now, that's what she did here in Chambade. When she was attacked, I think because of the sensitization, she ran one of the security of the local leaders, including the OC police. And as she was still fighting with them, they came. And that's how the whole group was wiped out, the whole group of Chidawarime. So the line of the unending of crimes which are never concluded is not entirely correct. I have a report here by the CID. It has got all these cases, like for instance, many cases here of what has happened and what has a total of 68 cases have been identified, including these murders. And many of the people have either been killed, some of the people have been killed, like the Chidawarime group. Like for instance, okay, let's take the case of kidnap and murder of Nagrinya, Maria Gateni, and Kitayimba Roni. You remember the girl called Nagrinya who was kidnapped and killed in Mukono? Before killing the victims, the suspects obtained their mobile money PIN numbers of the two victims. They later withdrew Uganda shilling 260,000 from Nagrinya's mobile phone, number this, and from Kitayimbo's mobile phone. So eventually these people were caught. The following suspects were taken to Mwanga 2 court on 29th September, and remanded to Zira. These are Kasoro, Kopori Yamu. Then you have people like Jumba Mulunda. Then two AK-47s were recovered, and so on and so forth. And then what I will do, I will tell Grace Akulo to publish, because this is the case of Nagrinya, this is the case of Chidawarime, the ones who killed the five people at Kisojo. And what I will ask Akulo is to give the country a brief about all these murders, even the killing of Joan Kagezi. The killers were identified, but some were abroad, and they were supposed to use the Interpol to look for them. So that line that all these cases never end, are never concluded, is not wholly correct. This is number one. Now, number two, General Mramba, if he can be attacked, how about we, the ordinary people? The general if he's not alert and the population is not alert, can be attacked. Because you must have heard that the generals have blood, unless you have discovered that the generals don't have blood. But if they have blood, they can be attacked. Now, in the case of Katumba, he had also made mistakes, because apparently he was moving without a follow car. That he used to have a follow car when he was a CDF, but when he became a minister, he was not moving with a follow car. He was moving with one escort and with a driver. Now that one was, I didn't know that, because a four-star general, given that we still have some of these isolated incidents, he should be having a follow car, and now he has it. Because if he had had a follow car, that one would not, it would not have been easy to do, to attack him. But even then, the bodyguard reacted, and that's how he chased away the killers, and two people died, but he saved himself, the bodyguard, and the general, although he was injured. But when something like this happens, it is because the whole country was relaxed. They were not not like when we got mobilized with Nachambade there, and now we are now mobilized. Like, for instance, these fellows who attacked Katumba, after they met a traffic police, but the traffic police was not armed. He tried to stop them, they ignored him, they passed. So you can see now, these people are using our laxity, our peace, to commit crime. But as Nachambade said, when you provoke us and we wake up, what will you do? Because we shall eventually get you. Now the traffic police are going to be armed. So you no longer come and pass by the traffic police like they did. They would be armed now, or they would be paired with armed people. You try to pass, they shoot you. So therefore, it is not not correct to say the general, because therefore, it is because there were weak elements in the security of the general that this happened. But it cannot continue. It cannot continue. We shall react. During this time of that insecurity, when they were killing women in Entebbe, killing women in Nansana, you remember those killings? We mobilized LDUs. They were attacking factories. They wanted factories, I think, to close. We mobilized and guarded all the factories. LDUs were everywhere, and the crime was defeated. So therefore, the story by the monitor, that the people are worried, the elite are worried, please. Yes, they may be worried because of your misinformation, but I'm telling you that we shall defeat this insecurity like we did it in the past. And I thought I should alert you on this. So my comrade Nachambade, when she became a hero, I looked for her in, is it Karungu? And I recruited her. She was a nurse there, local nurse. I said, you come and be nurse of special forces. So she's now one of my warriors. I normally find her at VIP checking corona and so on. So I thought she should come and give you her testimony of how insecurity was stopped in the Masaka area by getting rid of the Chidawarime gang. They were all either killed or arrested. I thank you. Good night.
Well, the presidential address on the COVID-19 situation in the country has just come to a close in 10 minutes to the top of the hour. We'll get right into NBS Live at 9.
This is NBS Live at 9.
And we kick off our broadcast with a rise in COVID-19 cases that has